Well, today I'm talking to number one New York Times bestselling author, Dr. Michael Roizen. His new book, The Great Age Reboot, Cracking the Longevity Code for a Younger Tomorrow. And joining him, also one of the co-authors, Albert Ratner. Thank you so much for talking with me here today.
It's our privilege. Thank you.
Well, you know, at some point, I'm reading that at some point, maybe people are going to be able to live till 110, 120, 130. It's going to become common. But here's the question. Are we going to be cyborgs?
No. In fact, the interesting thing is you're going to get to be rebooted back to a younger age. So there are 14 areas of active aging mechanism research, at least 14, which have all changed animals from the equivalent, two species each, and at least each of these 14 areas, from the equivalent of 90 to the equivalent of 40 in human terms. So you're going to get to be able to be younger, longer, and functional longer without changing species.
Wow. So tell me, there's got to be consequences, right? If everybody's going to be living longer, there's going to be more people on the planet. So how can we sustain?
I'm going to let Albert take that one because he's much better at that than I am.
And Albert, tell me about what you do. Tell me about what your day job is.
I've been a real estate developer. I had a national company, developed all the country. We developed the Nets. We own the Nets, New Jersey Nets, developed that stadium.
Barclays Place.
In Brooklyn, oh, wow. New York Times building, Staples Airport.
So he was the chair and co-CEO, chair of the board and co-CEO for 25 years of four city enterprises.
No, because I read that you part, one of the people that you wrote the book was with a demographer. That's
Albert.
Excellent.
So everything we did was based on what happened to people. Most of our development were in cities that had lower incomes. And we discovered that there would be a shortage of workers. Mm. So we went into Brooklyn, New York, for example, and put a project together called Metro Tech, had 16,000 employees, took people out of the projects to do that. So the answer to it is that we took a look at it. We started writing the book. It was based on all the research that was taking place medically. Got halfway through the book, discovered it was going to have great demographic changes, added Peter Linneman to the book. Mm-hmm. And in doing it, Peter and the doctor came up with the fact that the death rate today is 9.2 people per 1,000. It's going to go down to 2.7 per 1,000, which is an enormous difference. That does two things. The first thing it does to the individual, if you're 25 or younger, you're going to live to 125. If you're 75, you're going to live to 100. And that then causes the second effect, which is an enormous population increase, which we need because the birth rates have gone from 5.5 per woman down to below 2. And we're actually short people to work to carry on the country that we have. So we end up with 117.5 million more people, giving us 451 million people. The Congressional Budget Office says this is going to be 33 million people. Well, as a result of all of this, you begin to get more workers. So a couple things happen. When you have fewer deaths and more healthy people, medical costs go from 18 down to maybe 10. Mm. You could save $1 trillion. Mm-hmm. And then you get
from 18.9% of GDP down to, in fact, in the book, we thought it would be about 14%.
Wow.
It isn't that there will be decreased medical costs. They just won't keep increasing faster than GDP.
Right.
And they're less costly too. Then the second thing is you get 50%. When you get older, you're still going to work. So I'm still working. and I'm much better now than I was 25 years ago. So you get all this additional productivity. All of this happens only because of what's happening in research, because of the genome discoveries.
And you talk in the book about some of those things that are going to help people. It's gene splicing, right?
Gene editing or gene splicing, correct?
Yeah, what are some of the other things?
Well, let me go over. There's some things that are very expensive and some cheap. But one of the things we know about is artificial intelligence. And they've used that at both the Gladstone in San Francisco and here at the Cleveland Clinic to look at all the drugs already approved by the FDA and to see, do any of them block the attachment of tau and amyloid to neurons and ganglia cells in the brain? And it turns out that Gladstone found that, in fact, a very cheap drug, Bumex, butimetadine, it's a $4 a month water pill, blocked 70% of the attachment. They then looked at a 12 million person database, and the people who took that water pill as opposed to others had a 70% reduction in Alzheimer's and dementia. The same thing was done at the Cleveland Clinic, a little bit different, using the IBM quantum computer. And it turned out Viagra did the same thing and blocked 69% of the people who took that as opposed to other either drugs for pulmonary hypertension in women or other erectile dysfunction drugs in men. So that now is in a randomized controlled trial to see if that prevents it, and the two together as well. So that's one way of using artificial intelligence. There's therapeutic plasma exchange. There's bionic parts. The Winston team just won the contest to 3D print a functional human liver. There's mass production of stem cells without immunogenicity. There's the reduction of inflammation. There are literally 14 different areas. Induced tissue regeneration, epigenetic reprogramming, where you can take a white fat cell, regress it to a mother fat cell, turn it into a brown fat cell, and eliminate obesity, type 2 diabetes, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, etc. So there are literally 14 things that have been shown in at least two animal species, most of which are beginning to move into human trials. So we think, that's why we think within 10 years, Kim, you're going to be able to, not that you need to, but you'll be able to regress yourself to a younger person.
Yeah, it's funny. I mean, I've changed just a few things in my life now. And like when you look at pictures, I look younger. That's the thing, is that you talk about there are things that we can do right now that we have control over. What are a couple of those things?
Right. So the first part of the book, the first third of the book is on the science and where it's going. The next third of the book is on the economics, population, how you can benefit from this boom, right, what to do with your own finances. The last third is there are 180 choices you can make that slow the rate of aging and system by system. So at some time in the future, you may be able to go in a car wash at one end as a 90-year-old and come out a 40-year-old at the other end. But for now, it looks like it's organ by organ. And so what are for instance, for the brain, there are 33 choices you can make that have been shown to change the rate of brain aging in at least two studies in humans. So let me give you some. It is as simple as a tablespoon and a half of extra virgin olive oil a day, or an ounce of blueberries a day, or smelling four things a day, or adding speed to the games you play, your brain games you play. It isn't crossword puzzles or executive functional memory games.
I love that, because those other ones are really difficult. But for the speed games, I'm like really fast. Like people are like, how do you even do that? Like, so that's a good sign, right?
Well, it's enlarging your hippocampus. So it's much less likely, if you're practicing those, that you're going to, 18 hours over a 10-year period, essentially 2 hours a year, wasn't done that way. It was 10 hours in the first month, 4 hours in month 11, 4 hours in month 35. Three randomized controlled trials showed over a 40% reduction in dementia if you did speed of processing games for just 18 hours over 10 years.
Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing. How How should we be thinking about old age? What you know, so, anybody watching this right now?
So old age doesn't have to be old anymore. And that's what's going to happen. By the way, you can find out all the studies and the links to it. The studies are in the book. At the back of the book, there's a reference, but they're also on our website if you want just links to it at greatagereboot.com. And there's an app you can download that helps coach you day by day to gradually do this called Reboot Your Age.
Yes. And, you know, I'm all about being healthier and trying to stay, you know, stay out of the medical maze because it's, and you're saying that we're going to be of a certain age, but we're going to be living younger.
That's exactly right.
And living younger, meaning we're going to be feeling, you gave an example of being 90 and being like 40. It's hard to imagine. I mean, it's just hard to imagine. Is it going to be accessible? Do you think?
No, that's exactly the people are skeptical until you say, well, how long did your great grandparents live? Well,
that's
they lived
true.
Maybe 41. And how long are your grandparents? I mean, and how long are you living? So we've expanded this by 2.5 years every 10 years. It's going to go with at least an 80% probability by 30 years in this 10-year period, which really gives you an enormous opportunity. So you shouldn't say, I'm going to wait for this to happen. You should take that opportunity because you can plan for it and be much more, how do I call it, life will be much less stressful if you've planned for it and taken the appropriate actions so that you keep each of your organ systems old. You don't want to have an old, if you will, leg and a young heart.
Right.
You want everything to be young.
Everything.
I have 20 grandchildren and 15 great-grandchildren.
Oh, my.
And they've come to visit us. None of them live in Cleveland. And they come to visit us. I get down on the floor with my grandkids, and we play. And they walk on a beam, and I'm doing things that my parents never could have done.
Right.
And the wisdom we gain, we know so much more. I know more people. I can do more things. So I don't know what it means to be 94. My wife says I'm 12, and she hopes I'll grow up to be maybe 20 before I die. But I used to be a basketball player, and I used to be able to jump real high. I don't have to jump real high now.
Yeah,
I get down on the floor and see grandkids. I never dreamed.
My mom is 95, and like people can't believe it. They were kind of studying her in the hospital because, you know, she heals so quickly and bounces back like from everything. One last question. One of my favorite parts in the book was seriously semi-serious predictions. Okay. What are two of your favorites?
Well, my favorite being a basketball, not a player, but a fan, is that there's a basketball player, the Greek freak. And my favorite is that that 40 years from now, he'll be playing with his son and grandson on the same team.
Yeah.
So but these are all, if you will, some of them are tongue in cheek. So that's one of my favorites, actually, of all of them. And the other, the anti-aging tacos is one of the ones, because there are some, if you will, we've got a website, greatagereboot.com, where people can ask questions, and they've sent us questions on over 50 supplements or small molecules, and about 18 have real data. And so maybe in the anti-aging taco, you put in the real something that actually helps you get younger. That's one of those supplements.
It was the last one I read on that list. It was very funny. The Great Age Reboot by number one New York Times bestselling author, Dr. Michael Roizen, and also Albert Ratner joining in. He's a co-author here and he is a demographer. You can get this at your local bookstore. You can get it online everywhere. And one more time, where can people reach out to you? What's your websites?
It's greatagereboot.com. The book name, greatagereboot.com.
It was great. Thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you, Kim.
Thank you. Great question.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.